There's something on my mind and I just gotta say something. There's a lot of guys out there who are like 17, 18 years old contemplating marriage. How can you be 18 years old and reach the conclusion that you're ready for marriage? I mean, it's just crazy, you know? These guys, they meet these girls and they think they want to spend the rest of their lives with these girls, but I mean, they're 18-year-old girls. I mean, they're 18. You have any idea how much people are going to change, at least in their behavior, from age 18 to just 21? You really think that cute, fun 18-year-old is going to stay that way for the rest of her life? I mean, come on, man. People's behavior changes. I mean, just because you're in high school and things are really fun and really good, that doesn't mean that it's going to be that way when you're out of high school. I mean, there's no pressure on your relationship in high school. All the problems you have in high school are really just superficial. You know, when you get out into the real world and you have to pay your own bills, and there's the water bill, the light bill, you know, we got to get diapers for the kids, food. When there's actually pressure applied to the relationship, then those relationships aren't so fun. Not everything is so fun. I mean, believe me. I mean, at 18, nobody's ready to get married. I don't care if your parents did it or your great-grandparents did it. It's not 1963, it's not 1947, okay? It's a very different world. So if you're thinking about getting married at 18, a lot of you guys are running off to the military and then getting married, please think about it. Do you have any idea how many women you're gonna meet between now and the time you die? I mean, come on, you know? What about her? What about all the guys she's gonna meet? You think she really knows what she wants at 18? I mean, come on, think about it. It's just crazy. How old do you think somebody should be before they get married? I don't think marriage is a good idea for a man at all, but if you're gonna get married, I think no matter who you are, male or female, should be at least 25. If you're a man, I say you should be about 45, marrying a 25-year-old. But anyway, you guys tell me what you think. This is one of my favorite places. I like Creek Street. I've showed you guys Creek Street before, but this is Married Man's Trail. And it's like right downtown too. That's what's really cool about it. One of the things I like about this community is that, you know, people actually know who you are, as opposed to a big city where, you know, people couldn't care less. It's a lot of nice people in this town, a lot of good people, a lot of positive influences for young people too. I think it's a really good place to raise a family. Okay, it's not the best place if you're a single guy, but if you're looking for work or you have a family and you look for a good place to raise your kids, this is a good place, a good community. Not that the community doesn't have its problems, you know. We have issues with drugs just like all communities. Suicide is really high here in Alaska. Alcoholism is pretty high here in Alaska. I think it's the highest in the union. But there's a lot of positives, you know. The good thing about this industry here in Alaska is that people actually make things, and there's solid, tangible things that you can really get involved with here in Ketchikan. It's not just real estate and trying to flip houses and cafes and stuff like that, you know. It's like a real economy here. Interesting thing about Ketchikan is it sort of has qualities of an actual city without like a lot of the negative stuff, like the crime, the murder, the rape, the robbery. I mean, you know, I mean, it's kind of congested in the actual city. It's actually kind of dense, the population that is. But then even within the city, you can find places like this. So it's easy to find a lot of things. Okay, people ask me, what is it like to be a black man in Alaska? Well, let me tell you something. I've been called a nigger everywhere I've been. And that includes Flint, and that includes Ketchikan. But racism isn't really a big problem for me here in Alaska. At least not here in Ketchikan. I haven't really dealt with many troublesome people. Now, interesting thing is, you know, I feel more comfortable here than I did back in Flint. Oh, nice. I don't know if you can see this, but there's still snow up there. I don't even know the name of this place. Yeah, there's plenty of churches here. All kinds of denominations, Mormons, all that stuff. I mean, more than you would think on a little island like this. I mean, a little town like this. But there's a lot here. You know, there's a lot of bars here too, actually. A lot of churches and a lot of bars.